Mrs. Louise Warner. Thanks for having me in your brand new home. What project are you working on at the moment?
Well, our most recent project is we're putting in a veggie garden so that we can put in a sub pod recommended by Jill, a worm farm.
You're welcome. It is looking very good here. It's exciting.
Thanks.
Now, you are also not just an avid gardener, but you're an avid reader. Is there a book that you've been reading, or what's the last book that you really enjoyed?
Well, I was thinking about this and I slightly cheated because I started rereading a book I really like. This book was recommended to me by my brother. It's called Divine Jihad. It's by Esther Ahmad. And it's a story of a young woman from Pakistan who's in an Islamic family. And she actually signs up to be a suicide bomber. And before she can go through with her promise, she becomes a Christian. And in her country, that's a very dangerous decision. And she then faces potentially death for her decision. And it's a very fascinating story. I'm really looking forward to continuing to reread that. I got a little way in yesterday.
Yeah. Sounds heavy, but is it kind of the hope?
There's a lot of hope in it. And she responds to that really difficult situation with so much peace and such a willingness to go through suffering that I find it really inspiring.
Yeah. And now if you're cleaning or cooking, do you A, listen to music, B, the radio, C, TV, or D, silence?
Usually silence, because I'm extremely task-oriented. And if I start doing something, I won't hear what's going on in the background. But occasionally, if I'm in a holiday mood, I might put on some music. Or if the house is too quiet, maybe Dave's away or something, I might put the TV on in the background. But quite often, I'll just get on with it in silence.
And is that also silence because you're a teacher? You might, after teaching all day, you prefer that?
I'm not sure. It's possible. But I've probably always, to some extent, liked quietness.
So as I said, you are a teacher. What year are you teaching at the moment?
I'm teaching year three at Mid Coast Christian College, formerly Taree Christian College.
Yes, and at MCC, what is it that you like about teaching?
When I originally decided to go into teaching, I had thought about a position that I could use the gifts and talents God's given me and share the gospel and do it in a way that will have an impact. And so not many people remember the name of their family lawyer, even though they do important work. Or perhaps even their doctor, who also do very important work. But a lot of people, if you ask them someone who's had an impact on their life, will actually say a teacher. And so my reasoning was that I enjoy learning, I enjoy being around kids and teaching them. But most importantly, it's such an important opportunity to share the gospel.
And so you're at Mid Coast Christian College. What's the difference about teaching in a Christian school, and how do you find that helpful for that opportunity?
We're really encouraged to integrate a Christian worldview into every subject we teach. And it can be difficult at times in math and different things.
Noah's Ark, two by two.
Two timetables right there. Yeah. But there are ways to do it, and we did PD recently on looking at how we can put God's big story of creation and the fall, redemption and restoration, and use that kind of framework to put it into all of our teaching. And when we kind of started to explore this, we could find more natural ways to do it, so you're not just tacking on a Bible verse to a lesson that doesn't really have any relevance. But we also do devotions every morning. I read the 1 year Bible for kids at the moment because I found it to be brilliant. At simplifying the Bible in a way that kids can understand, but still having really amazing lessons about God's character and who he is in it. Some of the devotionals that you find for kids are very moralistic. You should have this behavior if you want to please God and that kind of thing. Whereas what our students really need to know is who God is, and the relationship that we can have with him.
Yeah. Mm. So what was that Bible book called?
The one that I'm reading to my students is the 1 Year Bible for Children. And I can look it up for you and we can post a link or something.
Yeah, nice. Oh, that's getting official with this podcast. I'll see below in the comments for the link. So teaching at the school, has there been a special time or a specific moment that stands out to you where you've had that opportunity?
I feel very privileged to have had a number of chances to share the gospel with kids through the lessons that we teach day to day. But there are specific instances that stick out as well where I've felt in my heart that I should give an opportunity for students to hear the gospel and respond to it. Because we'll often share aspects of the gospel and remind children that God's died for their sins, so that we don't have to make that payment ourselves. But to then take that step further and say, you know, this is the kind of prayer you could pray if you want to start that journey. And if you want to, come and see me after class. I'll talk to you at recess or lunch if you don't want to talk to me now. And I have had a student on a couple of occasions, but one in particular came and said, I want to speak to you after class. I want to become a Christian. And so I stayed at recess and was able to pray with that student so that they could start their journey as a new believer. So that was pretty special.
That is very special. Mm. Yeah. So the last couple of years have been big for everybody. We've had, you know, bushfires, floods, pandemics and so forth. You've been a teacher during that pandemic. You've gotten married. You've built and moved houses. How are you? How's that all been for you?
It has been a hard 2 years. I think being married has been helpful a lot of that time. We haven't had much conflict in our marriages yet. And so having someone at your side to reassure you at times and to keep on going, I have found helpful. I think having a really solid foundation in knowing God and knowing that he's good and that he's faithful has probably been the most helpful thing. I've always in my family been known as someone who's fairly level-headed and don't respond too emotionally when things happen, but I still will process things and, you know, spend time outside in nature and praying and things like that. And I think to be able to deal with the challenges of life and of these last 2 years, for me, the thing that does keep me steady and that person who doesn't seem to be so rocked by things that happen around me is that I know that God is with me every step of the way, and I know that I have a great family that I can call on if I need them. I know that God is good and that there's promises in the Bible that he can work everything together for good, and that I might not be able to see how things are going to turn out, but I do know the one who does know how things will turn out, and that I don't need to rely on my own understanding. I can put my trust in God.
Yeah, that's definitely helpful. What are some things, I guess, specifically that you find helpful in your life to get to know God better and deepen that as well?
I think the most helpful thing that we can be doing is knowing our Bible. A lot of times when I have felt God's presence the most is when I've been outside in nature. I grew up on a big farm, and so if I was really upset or cranky with someone, I would often go for a walk and just talk it out with God. And sometimes as I was doing that, I would have little thoughts come into my mind that I didn't know, you know, they hadn't come from myself. So I knew that they'd probably come from God. And the way I could tell if they were really from God is if it matched up with what it says in the Bible. And so through those times of praying and knowing the Bible, I could know what God was saying to me and how to move forward or deal with that situation. And often there was conviction in that of, well, actually, I didn't handle the situation as well as I could, or I could give someone the benefit of the doubt. But also him encouraging me and, helping me to deal with different things. So I think, prayer and spending time outside with God and or just a quiet space with God, and also playing the piano or singing, I find quite helpful to express myself to God, but to praise him. And I also find a lot of peace in that relationship.
So you're going to finish now by playing and singing us a song? Oh, no, no. can we wrap up? Do you mind praying for the women of Coast?
Sure. Dear God, we just thank you that we can spend time in your presence. We thank you that we can know you personally. We thank you that you offer us hope and a future and a solution, and all the things that we need, God, can be found in you. I pray for the women of Coast that you would help us to continue to get to know you more. I pray that you'd help us to look for opportunities to share the gospel with others in the situations that you put us in. And I just pray a special blessing, Lord, that you would help us to know you more. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.